Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I wanted to do a comparison review of two different eye primers today. The first eye primer is the MAC Please Hold eye primer, which I paid about $8 for, and then the second primer is the Sephora Perfecting eye primer, which I paid $14 for. As you know, I do sell Avon and MAC products, and it's my goal to always give you honest reviews of the products with my personal experiences and my thoughts on them. This is a product that I'm not such a fan of, and I will talk about that in this video and let you know why I'm not a fan. Okay, so let's get started with the MAC Please Hold eye primer. It comes in a compact like this. I do like the packaging. It has a mirror, and this is in the shade medium to dark. I believe it comes in one other color, like a light color. And it is tinted, and it's a creamy formula that feels very smooth and nice to the touch. However, I will say that I was very disappointed with this product. So I did get this product, and I tried it out over the course of probably like about a week and a half before I just gave up. This product does the opposite of what it's supposed to do. So when I think of an eye primer, what I'm looking for is something that will help my eyeshadow stay true to color and prevent creasing. Those are the two big main concerns. I don't care quite as much about like coverage of any veins or anything, although eye primers can neutralize that. And this one does do that because it's tinted. I don't think it would really work for darker skin tones because, as you can see, this is the medium to dark shade and it's not really all that dark, so that's a disadvantage. But the problem with this is that the formula just causes creasing, which is crazy because you get a primer to avoid that. And I tried using very little primer. I tried building up the primer so that I was using more product before I put my eyeshadow on. And no matter what I did, within about an hour and a half, every time I used this product, I would get creasing. And it's very strange because you would think that before a product reaches the market, you know, they would have that worked out, especially since that's the purpose of the product. So I wouldn't recommend this primer for that reason. Now, I do obviously enjoy and like a lot of other Avon and MAC products, and I'll, you know, talk about those too in other videos, but this product is just a weak product that they really need to improve. And I would say save your $8. Spend it on something else or other products from MAC if you're curious about exploring the line. And yeah, so the next product I got, because I was so frustrated with this one, and you know, I could have returned the primer, I think, from MAC, but I just felt like I should save it as like a testament, basically, and an example of the product so that I can show people the product and talk about it and, you know, basically recommend that they stay away from it, just because I consider it a waste of money. And I don't feel that way about a lot of other MAC and Avon products that I would recommend. So the next product I got when I went to Sephora in search of another eye primer, and that is the Sephora Perfecting eye primer. And comes in a tube, obviously, and basically it's not tinted. It's pretty colorless. It comes out white, but it you know, shears out over your eyelid, and you really only need a smidgen, like less than a pea-sized amount, like an eighth of a pea-sized amount per eye does the job for me. And I just find that it, you know, it does everything it's supposed to. It helps your eyeshadow stay true to color, and it really does prevent creasing even on hot and humid days. It is a little bit pricier, but it's still less than like the Urban Decay Primer Potion and some of the other primers out there. So $14 at Sephora, I believe, $14 or $15, and I would recommend the Sephora Perfecting Eye Primer. I definitely think it does the job, and you know, if you can save up the money to get it, if it's a little bit pricier than what you're looking for, I would still recommend it, just because if you do the math, like, you know, $14, let's say you use it once every day for 2 weeks, that's $1 a day, and then once you start using it after those 2 weeks, obviously the cost of what you invested in, it works itself out, so you're really you're investing in a product that's going to last you a long time. I really do think that this product is going to last me for months just because of how little I have to use to get the job done. So I would definitely recommend that. And thank you for watching. I have more videos coming up soon. Some makeup tutorials, some reviews, things like that. And I will be talking about Avon and MAC products as well as makeup from other makeup lines, and just exploring with you and sharing my personal experiences with all different types of makeup. So I will talk to you guys later, and thanks again. Bye.